Good morning to you all students. Let us begin with the next lecture hours, which is there on the electric field only. Second part we are going to discuss, which is of course main topic hours is electrostatics. Here we have the previous knowledge with us, which is already there with you, that is electrostatic force, Coulomb law, then electric field, which is the force with experienced by unit positive charge, so F upon Q naught. Q naught is the test charge and Q is the source charge. We have already done with the electric field due to point charge, due to end charges and continuous charge distribution, on which we have the questions at the end of this slide, just to revise with you. So objective of this slide is we have to study about the electric field lines, we have to study about the properties of electric field lines. Let us begin with electric field line. We have already discussed electric field, which is due to the force only, like in gravitational force. Because of the gravitational force, there is gravitational field, like we have done in class 11. Similarly, because of electrostatic force, there is always an electric field around the charge. To represent electric field, we are simply taking the help of a line or a curve, which is of course an imaginary line, because we can experience the force, we can experience the field because of that force. But to represent it, we are taking the help of the imaginary lines or curve along which a unit positive charge would tend to move when free to do so. That unit positive charge we have already discussed, it is negligibly small, positively charged. Then our field will be equal to the force, and the direction at any point is given by the tangent at that point. Like at P point, the direction is along the tangent, that is shown by EP. At Q point, it is along the tangent along EQ. And of course, if the lines are closer, that means the field is strong. If the lines are apart, it means the field is weak. Here at A point, of course, the electric field is stronger than at B point. So this is simply telling you that relative closeness of the lines at some place, it is giving you idea about the intensity of electric field at that point. Again, to focus, these lines are imaginary lines, but the field which they are representing is of course the real. We can experience that field. Let us start with the properties of the electric field lines. First property is electric field lines, they originate from the positive charge and terminate at the negative charge. Like we have discussed earlier also, positive charge lines are moving outward. Because if I keep the test charge here, then the force will be like, this is positive charge, source charge, test charge is always positive, so it has to be in the outward direction. Here if I put the test charge, that is always positive, then the field will be going inside. So with the negative charge, it is going inside, with the positive charge, it is coming outside. So here also you can see the charge is starting from the positive charge and ending at the negative charge. So this is the very first property with you. Second property says that electric field lines, they never intersect each other. Because if I say the field lines are intersecting each other like shown here, then they are meeting at a point, and that point I will be having two directions of the electric field, which is not possible, because at one point I can have only one direction of the electric field. So no two lines can cross each other. Next property says it does not have breaks in between. Like it has to be a continuous line. It is starting from the positive charge, ending at infinity. It cannot have breaks, because if there are breaks, that means there is absence of the electric field, which is not there. Field is decreasing with the increase in the distance. Of course, it is more here. It is becoming weak when you are going till infinity, but it will never have breaks in between. They are perpendicular. Electric field lines are perpendicular to the surface of the conductor like this. If we say they are not perpendicular, it means they are making some angle. Then there has to be a component along the x direction, and due to that component, the charge should start move. Moving charges means current, but we are talking about the electrostatics. So in electrostatics, electric field is always perpendicular to the surface of conductor. Next property says The relative closeness or thinness, that is giving you the idea about the strength of electric field, we have discussed earlier also. If the field lines are more, it means the field is stronger. Here the field lines are less apart, they are more apart, then the field is weak. So it means if they are closer, field lines are less apart, then the field is strong. If they are more apart, field is weak. So this is what we have written also. If lines are close together, then the field is strong, and when the lines are moving apart from each other, then the field is weak. Here in this example, we have tried to show that if the charge is more, then the field lines has to be more. If the charge is less, then the field lines has to be, number of lines you will be drawing less, and that should be in the ratio of the given charges. If here you are drawing 8 lines supposingly, here it should be only 4. So you have to count the number of lines if such a problem is coming across you for the conceptual problems or otherwise. Next property says the number of field lines is directly proportional to the magnitude of the charge and inversely proportional to the square of the distance. This formula we have already derived in the previous class, that is electric field due to a point charge. So it is dependent upon the charge. If the charge here is more, then the field will be more strong. Here it is negative charge, so of course the lines are getting into it. And if you go apart, then inversely proportional to the square of the distance from the source charge. For considering the electric field, you should be able to take the test charge anywhere at a particular point where you want to find the electric field. If I want to find electric field here at this point, then I will put my test charge at a given point. And if it is at a distance small r, then I can calculate field at this point due to this source charge. Of course, my test charge has to be negligibly small. We have discussed in the previous class. Next line says that electric field lines, they contract longitudinally, that is lengthwise. Here, like, that is showing the attraction between the unlike charges. Here, like you can see, both are unlike charges, one is positive and other is negative, so they are contracting by their length. This is taken as the length, distance between along the x-axis when you are taking. And if the like charges are there, then they exert lateral pressure in the direction perpendicular to their length. So this direction is perpendicular to its length, so here it is exerting the lateral pressure. So if you are having both negative charges, then again the lines will be drawn like this, but the direction of the arrow has to be changed, because for negative charge it has to go inside, and for the positive charge, as shown, it has to go outside the charge, but they will exert lateral pressure as shown in this diagram. So these both the diagrams should be clear to you. Here lengthwise, to show the attraction, they are contracting. Here they are expanding. Or you can see the lateral pressure is exerted perpendicular to its length. That is showing the repulsion between the like charges. Of course, they cannot form closed loops. Closed loops means they are not going inside the body. Like here I have taken a line charge. We have discussed about the continuous charge also in the previous class. So if this is the line charge which is negative, then from the positive, the field lines will come out and will end at the negative plate like this, but they will not pass through the plate. Similarly, here also lines are starting from the positive charge and they are ending at the negative charge, but they are not going inside the charged body. So they are not forming closed loop like in magnetic field you will study. Then they go inside the magnet also, the lines are there. It means it is inside the magnet, but here inside the charged bodies it is not there. So they will start from positive, they will end at negative, but they will not go inside the body. It means they will not form the closed loops. This is all about the properties of the lines. But if you want to show the uniform electric field, it is always shown by the parallel lines, which should be equidistant. It means between first and second line, this distance. Similarly, this distance between second and third line should be same. They are equally spaced parallel lines, but of course direction will always be from positive to negative. Here I have shown two parallel plates and the electric field is shown from positive to negative, because from positive they will originate and they will terminate at the negative plate. So this is again, both are showing you the uniform electric field. Whenever in the questions you have to draw the uniform electric field, it is drawn by the equispaced parallel lines with an arrow. Arrow is showing the direction of the field. Similarly, you can represent non-uniform field, but then you have now the lines like this, which are not equally spaced, like here. Here the field, when the lines are closed, field is stronger. Here at this point, field will be weak because the lines are apart. But for uniform field, lines are equally spaced. At every point, the value of the field will be same. Here, at like in this case also, you can see A and B point. Here at A point, the lines are more apart as compared to at B point. So at A point, field is weak, and at B point, field is stronger than at A. So distance between the lines is showing you the strength of the electric field. As you can see, P1 is closer to the source charge, so field here is stronger. But if I look at point P2, which is R distance is increased, so E, we have to prove that it is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the source charge and the test charge. This is a simple mathematically expression with you, which you have to prove. So you have to follow these steps. We are supposing P1 and P2 are the points which are at the distances R1 and R2. And let us suppose N is the number of field lines cutting an element area. Here, of course, you have to keep your concept which you have studied in class 11th. Here, of course, this is a source charge. We take the circle in 11th class we have taken, we could find the angle subtended at the center of the circle, then theta is given by the length of the arc upon radius. But if I have a sphere, in this case, when I have been taken charge at a particular distance from it, in all the direction, field will be same. And that I have already discussed in the electric field first lecture, that the shape is coming out to be spherically symmetric for a point charge. So this is a sphere around the source charge, but only one area is shown here of that sphere. And this is the center of the sphere. So angle subtended by this area and angle subtended by this area is coming out to be same, and that is written by delta tau, which is the sign for the steradian, which is solid angle, which is equals to area upon R square. You have studied this formula in class 11th as well. From here, you can calculate the value of the area, which is written as steradian R square, and thus by this knowledge you can find the number of field lines cutting a unit area at the point P1, which will be of course equals to N divided by this area. Similarly, you can find the number of field lines cutting a unit area at P2, which will be yours N upon R2 square delta tau. So, because we have already discussed that electric field strength, we are taking directly to the density of the field lines, and by keeping that point, we are drawing the number of lines this way. And if you find the value of E1 and E2, E1 upon E2, you are getting it equals to R2 square upon R1 square, or you can say that E is inversely proportional to R square. Next, there is a question for you. You have to obtain the formula for the electric field due to a thin wire of uniform charge density using Coulomb's law. We have already discussed linear charge density lambda, that is equals to dq upon dl, charge per unit length. So here what we have taken, let L is the length, then dx we have taken the small part, so lambda can be written as dq upon dx. If I have taken q as the total charge on this line, then lambda linear charge density can be written as dq by dx, or dq can be written as lambda dx. Now if you take the direction of this, this is of course same, this need to be drawn straight line from this point, and then you write this is the direction of E because it is positive charge outward, this angle is theta, this angle is also theta. Then you need to take, you can resolve dE into components, then this is dE cos theta, dE sin theta. Similarly, if I take the small part from this side, then dE will be acting along this direction, then you can take dE cos theta, dE sin theta. So similarly, if I keep continuing, all the sin theta components will cancel out in pairs and cos theta components will be added. So dE cos theta, that will be giving you the total value of E. Of course, you can find dE by the knowledge of Coulomb's law, that is yours 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught dq upon r square, because q naught test charge, that will cancel out in the formula of force. So you can replace dq by lambda dx, and then you are getting this expression. Of course, here you can take the value of r, which is equals to x square plus y square. And if you put the value of this dE, and then you can find the value of here from the diagram only, you can see tan theta will be equals to x upon y, or x can be written as y tan theta, or you can write dx equals to y secant square theta d theta. And you can find the E when you, here you have taken the distance, then the limit is from minus infinity to infinity. You can write it in terms of, if I take the limit 0 to infinity simply by multiplying with the factor 2. Now when I have converted dx into theta, then you have to take the limits for theta because the small variable is d theta, and so that theta you will be varying from 0 to 90 degree. So you simply take the integration of cos theta, which is equals to sin theta, and you can put the upper limit minus lower limit, and hence you can get this result, which is equals to E equals to lambda upon 2 pi epsilon naught y. By that previous knowledge, you can always write, if we have to find the electric field due to the continuous as well as discrete charges, that you have to take as a vector sum of both discrete and continuous charges. And this was the expression we have done for the discrete charges. 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught I have taken out for all. For the volume charge distribution, dq is to be replaced by rho dv. For surface charge distribution, it is to be replaced by sigma ds. For linear charge, it is given by lambda dl. This is of course around the volume, this is around the surface, this is around the length. So you have to take the integration this way. You have to add up all the things as per the question coming to you. You need to try more questions from your NCERT and from the other book. This is one more question for you, that how many electrons should be removed from the coin of mass 1.6 gram so that it may just float in the electric field of intensity 10 raised to the power 9 newton per coulomb, which is directed upward. So if field is directed upward, then the weight, of course, when you have to balance, this is weight of the body is acting downward. So force which is acting because of this field has to act in the upward direction for equilibrium, and force is given by QE. And you all know Q charge is quantized, so Q can be written as NE. So if you put the value Q equals to NE, then using this formula QE equals to mg, you can find the number of electrons which are to be removed. And see to it, mass is given in gram, you need to convert it into kilograms. Value of g you already know, 9.8. You can take even 10, no problem. Electronic charge, you know, 1.6 into 10 to the minus 19. And electric field is given in the question, 10 raised to the power 9 newton per coulomb. So this is the result you are getting. This is one more question with you, is to draw the electric field lines for a system of two charges such that first part says Q1, Q2 greater than 0. Greater than 0 means both are like charges, either positive or negative. Q1 is greater than Q2. So, number of lines from Q1 you will take out more as compared to Q2. Q2, and neutral point will always lie closer to the smaller charge. We have discussed earlier also. So here, if I want to make the system in equilibrium, then the force in this direction should be equal to the force in the opposite direction, magnitudes. And if by knowing if I have the test charge, then field should be equal in both the directions. Similarly, if you are having this case Q1, Q2 less than 0, then one is positive charge, another is negative charge. And again, you have to take care of the magnitude. This is given greater, so you have to draw more lines. Neutral point will always lie closer to the smaller charge, but it will not lie in between the line, because in between the line, if you take any point, then the direction of the force or field will come out in the same direction. Both should be in the opposite direction. So it has to be taken outside. You have to take care of all these things. Keep things up to this. Of course, next we will be in the next class. Thank you.